Let's start our first chapter, A Triumph of Surgery. I was really worried about Ricky this time. I had pulled up my car when I saw him in the street with his mistress, and I was shocked at his appearance. He had become hugely fat, like a bloated sausage with a leg at each corner. His eyes bloodshot and rheumy sat straight ahead, and his tongue lolled from his jaws. Here, narrator is saying that when Mrs. Pumphrey, a rich lady, takes her dog out for a walk, a nearby veterinary doctor who knows the lady sees the dog and is shocked as he sees that the dog looks like a bloated sausage with a leg at each end. He advises her to stop giving him unhealthy things to eat. Mrs. Pumphrey hastened to explain he was so listless. Mr. Harriet, he seemed to have no energy. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition, so I have been giving him some little extras between meals to build him up. Some malt and cold liver oil and a bowl of Horlicks at night to make him sleep. Nothing much, really. Here, Mrs. Pumphrey was explaining to Mr. Harriet that Ricky looks very tired. Mrs. Pumphrey is saying that she felt Ricky is suffering from malnutrition, due to which Ricky looks tired. Because of that, she is giving extra food between meals to build him up. Here, which kind of food she is giving? Malt, pot liver oil, a bowl of Horlicks at night to make him sleep. Nothing else, nothing much she is giving to Ricky. This extra diet is the reason why Ricky is overweighted. And did you cut down on the sweet things as I told you? Here, narrator is asking that, have you reduced the thing which he eats? Here narrator is saying that, is Mrs. Pumphrey reduced the sweet things which Ricky used to eat? Oh, I did for a bit, but he seemed to be so weak I had to relent. He does love cream cakes and chocolate, so I can't bear to refuse him. Yes, for some time I did, but I had to leave the harsh behavior because due to this Ricky seems tired. So I started giving him sweet food. He loves cream cakes and chocolates a lot. Whenever I see he likes these things, I can't be strict towards him for this. I looked down again, and the little dog that was the trouble, Tricky's only fault was greed. He had never been known to refuse food. He would tackle a meal at any hour of the day or night and wondered about all the things Mrs. Pumphrey hadn't mentioned. Ricky is greedy. He is tricky for what? He is greedy for food. Here, narrator is saying that Ricky is fond of eating. Whenever food is given to him, he had it and digested it. Here, narrator is thinking that there are lots of things about Ricky which Mrs. Pumphrey haven't told him yet. Are you giving him plenty of exercise? Here, narrator is asking to Mrs. Pumphrey that did he do? Who Did Tricky do any kind of exercise or any laborious work? You could say. Well, he has his little walks with me, as you can see. But Hodgkin, the gardener, has been down with lumbago, so there has been no ring throwing lately. As you see, he performed a little walk with me. But my gardener, Hodgkin, was suffering from lumbago. Due to this, Tricky is not playing or he is not able to perform ring throwing since few days. I tried to sound severe. Now, I really mean this. If you don't cut his food right down and give him more exercise, he is going to be really, ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a very strict diet. Here, narrator tried to narrator is trying to sound strict. He is saying that I really mean this. What he mean? He mean if Mrs. Pumphrey haven't cut off, cut off Tricky's meal and won't give him plenty of exercise, then really he will become ill. You have to make yourself strict. Here, narrator is saying this to Mrs. Pumphrey that you have to make yourself strict and give Tricky meals only. Don't provide him any extra food.